Dear ladies and gentlemen, I have thought about putting this video a long time ago, but was afraid that YouTube would use it as another excuse to shut us down for the third time, because the Muslims abhor and are terrified of the truth, would once more flag us down for hate speech, when in fact and reality, all we are doing as usual is revealing the horrible characteristics of the foundations of their cult belief system. Observe the convulsions and conflagrations within their utterly inhumane and archaic societies, and how the so-called revolutionaries for democratic rule are assaulting foreign reporters and observers, both male and female, by shouting, "Jew! Jew!" to justify their evil actions. How the tempo of attacks against Christians, their churches, and their homes has accelerated alarmingly, as well as against Hindus, Buddhists, and animists. I have thus decided, as a matter of urgency, to go ahead anyway and await whatever happens. I would like you all to understand that every single believing or fundamentalist Mohammedan Muslim must follow the two pillars that are the foundations of Sharia, Muhammad's Quran and Muhammad's Sunnah. I have already fully and comprehensively demonstrated in 780 chapters of my thesis, which you can read on my web in the name of Allah.org, that Muhammad's Quran and Sunnah are hate-mongering, war-mongering, misogynist, racist scriptures, and hence most assuredly ungodly. That Sharia is utterly incompatible with all human freedoms and dignities, and hence must never be allowed to take root in any of our democracies. Please also be aware that contrary to all of the Muslims' false propaganda, platitudes, and accusations, we do not discriminate against them, because it is they who discriminate against all of us, all those who do not believe as they do. Moreover, since Sharia incites its followers in every mosque and madrasa, religious Islamic school, to abhor, disobey, and insult our laws, institutions, constitutions, and our personal humanity, then based on the rule of law, prohibiting hate speech against other human beings, this alone should disallow Sharia's voice from ever being expressed on our soil. Considering the fact that we in the West have accepted and welcomed about 50 million of them who came begging and crawling to our countries, then their accusation that we do not allow them to integrate is utterly false. We have given them shelter, education, medication, freedom of belief and thought, financial help, etc., from our own hard-earned taxes, and they show us their gratitude by disrespecting our laws, our freedoms, our beliefs in our own countries, and undermining our hospitality, traditions, and security by attempting to bring to our shores the very depraved Sharia that they had escaped from in the first place. It is they who are not willing or able to integrate because they are prohibited by Sharia from ever assimilating into or amongst us, the infidels. Hence, what I am about to state or reveal to you with relevant Quranic and Hadith references is based entirely upon the beliefs of the followers of Muhammad and has absolutely nothing to do with hate speech, racism, or the fraudulent and Muslim self-serving term of Islamophobia. In fact, I dare any follower of Muhammad to refute anything I state and declare, not by insulting or threatening me, but with knowledge of their own scripture. The following is a list of questions that each and every one of you outside the land of Islam, that is in the territory of the infidel peoples, should ask yourselves and the Muslims. Can any believing Muslim in the land of the unbelievers be good, law-abiding, integrated and loyal citizens in our countries? Theologically, no. Because Muslims submit only to Allah. As well as you know by now, Allah is originally only the name of the supreme God of pagan Arabia, among 360 other stone deities, and hence, most definitely not the same as the God of Jesus, Moses, or Abraham. Religiously, no, because no other religion is accepted under Sharia except Islam, submission to Allah. Al-Imran 3.85. If anyone desires a religion other than Islam, submission to Allah, never will it be accepted of him. And in the hereafter, he will be in the ranks of those who have lost. Scripturally, no. Because the Muslims' allegiance is to Sharia based upon Muhammad's Quran and Sunnah. Textually, no. Because Muhammad's Quran and Sunnah are hate-mongering, war-mongering, misogynist, racist, and hence most definitely ungodly. Geographically, no. Because Muslims bow in reverence to Mecca in Arabia, to which they turn in prayer 5 times a day. Socially, no. Because a Muslim's devotion to Islam forbids them from ever making true friends with Christians or Jews. Al-Ma'idah 5.51. O ye who believe, take not the Jews, Yahud, and the Christians, Nasara, for your friends and protectors. They are but friends and protectors to each other. And he amongst you that turns to them for friendship is of them. Al-Tawbah 9.29. Qatilu, fight. Those who believe not in Allah, nor the last day, nor hold that forbidden which had been forbidden by Allah and His Apostle, nor acknowledge the religion of truth, Islam, even if they are of the people of the book, Christians and Jews, until they pay the jizya, onerous poll tax, with willing submission and feel themselves humiliated. Loyally, no. Because Muslims' allegiance is primarily to all other Muslims all over the globe. Al-Mumtahana 6.1. O ye who believe, take not my enemies and yours, Christians, Jews, Buddhists, Hindus, etc., as friends or protectors. Al-Tahrim 66.9. O Prophet, strive hard against the unbelievers and the hypocrites, Christians, Jews, and other non-Muslims, and be firm against them. Their abode is hell, an evil refuge indeed. Ishaq 2.31. Muslims are one ummah, community, to the exclusion of all men. Believers are friends of one another, to the exclusion of all outsiders. Politically, no, because Muslims must take instructions from their mullahs, spiritual leaders, who teach them equal opportunity hatred for all those who are not followers of Muhammad. Currently, 80% of humanity called Ummat al-Kuffar, nation of infidels, comprising all Christians, Buddhists, Hindus, Zoroastrians, Jews, animists, agnostics, atheists, pagans, etc. Al-Anfal 8.55. For the worst of beasts in the sight of Allah are those who reject Him. They will not believe. Al-Fath 48.13. And if any believe not in Allah and His Apostle, we have prepared for those who reject Allah a blazing fire. Domestically, no. Because Muslims are instructed by Muhammad's Quran to marry up to 4 women and beat and scourge their wives when they disobey them. Al-Nisa 4.34. Men are the protectors and maintainers of women because Allah has given the one more strength than the other and because they support them from their means. As to those women on whose part you fear disloyalty and ill conduct, admonish them, refuse to share their beds, beat them. Legally, no, because Muslims cannot accept the American or European constitutions as binding, since they are not from Allah, as well as they believe that the Bible has been corrupted and hence is now ungodly. Culturally, no, because Muslims belong to a culture that prefers death than life. Ibrahim 14.3. Those who love the life of this world more than the hereafter, who hinder men from the path of Allah and seek therein something crooked, they are astray by a long distance. Constitutionally, no, because Sharia is the nemesis of democracy. It does not allow for freedoms of religion, expression, or belief. Democracy and Islam is an oxymoron, a state of affairs that cannot possibly coexist. Every Muslim government in the world is dictatorial, autocratic, or theocratic. Spiritually, no. Because the Judeo-Christian tradition believes in a loving fatherly God, while Allah is never referred to as Heavenly Father, nor is He ever called love in the Quran's 99 excellent attributes. Moreover, Muhammad truly believed and asserted in his Quran and Sunnah that those who die in Islam are physically recreated in his whorehouse version of paradise to enjoy sexual, carnal, and sensual pleasures for eternity. 1400 years ago, Muhammad declared, "Silence means consent." Maybe this is why European and American Muslims are so definitely quiet and not speaking out about all the worldwide atrocities allegedly committed by so-called radical Muslims. Not once in the last 30 years has there been a major demonstration, whether in Europe or the USA, by the so-called silent majority Muslims, expressing their revulsion at acts of terror committed by these alleged radicals, shouting out loud, "Not in our name." Therefore, after much study, contemplation, and deliberation, Europeans and Americans should be very suspicious of all Muslims in their midst, especially all organizations that call themselves Islamic. They obviously cannot be both good Muslims and loyal Europeans or Americans. Call these shocking revelations whatever you will, but these are the facts based entirely in chapter and verse upon the Muslim scripture. Europeans and Americans had better believe this. The more who understand these realities, the better it will be for our democracies and our future generations to survive the onslaught of Muhammad and Islam. The clash between Islam and the rest of humanity is most definitely not a clash of civilization, but most assuredly a clash of beliefs and cultures. Muslims have publicly and repeatedly declared their intention to Islamize Europe and the USA from within. Europeans and Americans would be utterly insane and suicidal by ignoring these warnings. Ladies and gentlemen, please remember at all times, freedom never comes free.